Hi everyone. So today we'll see how to generate the Allure report for TestNG projects. Okay. So far we have seen Cucumber reporting, Extend reporting, Maven Cucumber reporting, and Cucumber reporting in our previous video. Right. So in this video we'll see how to generate the Allure report for TestNG. Okay. So this is a Allure page. I will simply go to the Allure page. So this is Allure page. You can see. So there are very detailed documents are given. Okay. So you can go by step by step, and you can get installed and configure the things as you require. So to start with, right? So get start. So we have to install the Allure in local level. In the local machine, right? So these are the guidelines. Set up for Linux and Mac and Windows, right? So for Windows, I just went with the manual installation where I have downloaded a zip file, right? So this Allure bat file. That comes with a zip file, right? So here is a link, right? So here you have to go to this link, and particular this is a file section you have to go. I will give you this URL to the description. Okay, so you have to download this file. Okay, though this file download as a zip file. Okay, so that zip file you have to make sure you are setting the environment variable for the same for the Allure bat, Allure till bin folder. Okay. So once your environment variable is set, right, so you can check for the version. Okay, so you have to check like this. So in my case, I have done already. So you can see the Allure version, right, 2.6.0 I have installed. Okay, so once the installation is done, right, so your environment variable for Allure is set up, and you are getting the right version, then we go for the reports configuration, right? So report configuration, I will come here. Okay, so the reference doc is completely all about how to install the Allure and how to set the configuration for the report. Okay, so how the Allure report looks. So this is how this Allure reports look. You can see this is the overview, right? So trend and what, how many suits, categories. So you can drag like this. So you can rearrange like this. So the way you want, right? So you up and down you can rearrange it. And so when it's come to the category, so how many categories we have, so ignore test cases, all the test cases are, and how many suits we have, right? So if you go to the graphics level, you can see the all the graphics level trends and everything, categories, and this is a timeline for the test cases and behaviors, like so you can categorize like a screen chart, anything like epic level, story level, you can you will see in report. Okay, so this is a behavior, and again this is a package. So how many packages we have in the project, right? So this is all the sample. This is a sample report that given by the Allure team, right? So this is this is how the report looks. Okay, so how to do this configuration, right? So report generation. Right, so here is the report generation. We have to scroll down little. So these are the report structure, they are explained. Okay, so now generating this, right? So you can, so we are just going with the TestNG, right? So for TestNG, you can go for a TestNG option here. So just simply click on this. So there are some dependencies we have to set, right? So these are the dependencies, right? So I will come here. So these are the dependencies that we have to set. So since we are using the Allure TestNG, we have to use this Allure TestNG dependency as well as this Allure SLIND, right? And reporting, we are using Allure Maven. Again, this one also needs to be set. And under the pom.xml, in the pom.xml, in the Maven SureFire plugin, right? So we have to set the things like this. Okay, so I just copied from their website, nothing else. Okay, so you can directly get it from here as well. So you have to make sure this property is added, right? The property aspect J version 1. The recent version also you can use. And in the dependency, this is Allure TestNG we need. And when it's come to the Maven SureFire plugin, this is a line that we have to pass in the argument line. Okay, and this is already we declared in the property file. That's it. So once you run the project, you can get the results in the Allure results folder. Okay, so now we'll come to the Eclipse, right? So Eclipse also you can see the same setup, I have done. So I just added these two dependencies and one on reporting dependencies, as well as the Maven CFR plugin. I am passing this argument line. So you can copy this from the website itself. Okay, and this is my TestNG XML suite file. Okay, so now we'll see how to generate this report. Okay, so I have two class files. So one is for doing the Bing search, one is doing for the Google search. Okay, and I am using for listeners to take the screenshot to and attach to the report if it is any failure on the test methods, right? Okay, so this is on test failure. So whenever the test is getting failed, right, so automatically the screenshot will be taken and append to the report. Okay, so this is a default screenshot method that options that coming out of from the Allure. You can see Allure add attachment. So this is I'm taking the screenshot, I'm attaching to this the default directory that where this Allure JSON get generated, right? So you can simply incorporate this into your test cases, right? So this is a first test case, bingosearch.com, bingo search. So where I am simply doing some bingo search. Okay, so this is my before class and this is my after class. Okay, so if you see this before class, right, so there are so many things you can configure. So this is a browser, description. So this will come up in the Allure report as well. Okay, before class I'm just starting the driver. And this line you have to make sure this path file URL is adding, you have added, right? And you have to initialize this set driver context, right? So that is a I test context that is for taking the screenshot, right? So we have to incorporate that one as well. And after class, right, I'm just closing the browser. So your description, so whatever the description you add here, that will come into the report. Okay, so when come to the test, right, so I have a three tests, 1, 2, 3 test cases. One is doing the search, and one is navigating back to the results, and one more thing is navigating forward as well as doing some assertion, right? So this assertion I am intentionally failing to show the results in the report, right? So you can see this, there are so many annotations that I have used here. So you can see the epic, feature, step, link, description, right? So these all annotations are it's to configure your report, in the Allure report, right? So if you say as a epic, then you can see the category under category, you can see as a epic. So when it is come, we usually get a epic, right? So epic will convert to the user story or product backlog item, future, right? So epic to feature to user story or product backlog item, from backlog item to task, right? So from task it will go to the steps or something like that. So this is how this hierarchy is maintained in the agile world, right? So you can see this is a epic. So what is the epic? I am just passing as a Bing search, and what is the feature? Doing the Bing search is a feature, and the step is I'm just searching the Allure report in the Bing search box. Okay, and this link also, if you want to give, you can give. So all these things will be shown in the report also, report as well. Okay, so I just grouped as a epic feature level, and the step is different step, but epic level, feature level, everything is same. Okay. And you can mention the severity level as well, right? So the severity level is a critical, blocker, something like that, normal, right? So if at all the test cases fail, no, you can highlight as critical or normal, something like that. Okay, this is one test case, and end of the test case you have to make sure that attaching the screenshot, right? So for screenshot we have to add these two methods. Okay, so this is one test case, and one more test case is a Google. So for Google also same only. So if you do the comparison, right, so I will show you the comparison, right? So here also I am using the before class, after class, and before setup, and same thing, I have added this file path, right? So So you can see here, so this epic is called a Bing search epic. This epic is called Google search epic, right? And feature is doing the Google search, and here the feature is doing Bing search, right? So only this I have configured that I have two epic, one epic for doing the Bing search, one epic for Google search under the respective features, right? So both test cases do the same operations, right? So once you done this, you can simply create one XML file. So you can create a simple XML file like this. So this is my XML file, right? So where I have given these two class files. One is Bing search. One is Bing search. One is Allure. Google search, right? So now you can see my Allure results looks empty. So I have only one. So I have only one environment property file is set up. Okay. So you have to create one environment property file here, right? So to define your browser setup and what's the environment stand, like, so you can give anything. These are the three options that they have given. You can go for a Chrome, browser and browser version, as well as the environment variables. Okay. So now I will do one thing. So this setups and everything is done. So we'll run the test cases. We'll run the project now. So you have to run as a Maven test now. So the execution is started. Yeah, the execution is started now. So first time it will do the Bing search, and the second test case is a Google search, right? Okay, so you can see JSONs are generated in the Allure results tab, Allure results folder, right? So here you can see there are two attachments, right? So since we have two test cases are failing, so two attachments are placed under the Allure results folder, right? So this is coming from here, right? So we are taking the respective screenshot and we are appending to this particular folder, right? So if you see this Allure add attachment, right? So that will do this job. So I'm just generating some UUID random ID to string, because this I have to generate this UUID, right? So quid ID, okay, I'm randomly generating and appending, placing under this Allure results folder, right? So now how to generate the report, right? So report is the JSON is ready now. So come to the terminal, right? So here what you have to do, you have to pass the command line Allure serve, right? So make sure you are into the particular this project directory. Okay, so I'm into my projects directory. I'm just passing this command. So now you can see the report is generated, right? So once you run the command in the terminal, right? So automatically the report will open. Now you can see the overall report, right? So we have six test cases, right? So each three. So each test cases has three. Each class has three tests, right? So one, this one, two, this one, three. Okay. So we have six test cases. And you can see this overall suit and categories, okay? And you can see here this environment details, right? This environment detail is coming from this property file that we seen, right? So Chrome, what is the Chrome version, browser version, right? And the lower normal, this is staging. Yeah, you can see lower normal and browser, I mean version, and what is the browser name, right? And these are the categories. We can go to the categories here, and the features, right? So features by the stories, like you can see. So one feature is, I mean, one Epic is doing the Bing search, and one is Google search. Okay, so we'll go to the categories now. So if you go to the categories, like you can see this. So this product categories has two types of product categories. If you go to here, you can see product categories by default. I mean, there are so much options we can go for it, but when it's come to the product category, right? So you have to configure the, again, one more configuration you have to additionally do. So if you want to change this, once again. Yeah, so here is the categories, right? So by default, it will support two categories. So one is a product defect if the test case is failed. So one is test defects if test is broken, right? So here, so that's what we are seeing here. So we are getting the product defects one, since our product, I mean, our test case is failed, right? So this is a category tab. When you come to the suite level, right? So you can see my suite level. So here we have like two suits, right? So I mean, one suit we have two test cases, two classes, like one is Allure TestNG Google search, and one is Bingo search, right? So you can see this, the first one, right? So when you click on this first one, doing Bing search, right? So if you go to this doing Bing search right side, right? So this doing Bing search is the my first test case, right? So if you scroll down, you can see here. So the description is doing the Bing search, right? So that is this doing Bing search is coming from here, right? So that is what I mean shown in the description. So this is a test description, right? So when you come down, I mean, in the overview, the severity is automatically taken as a normal. So I'm not controlling any severity here. I will show you where I'm controlling it. Okay, so the description, right? The description of the method. So this is coming from the description tab. You can see description of method is doing the Bing search, right? And the link also coming from this annotation only. Okay, so I'm simply passing www.bing.com. So when you come to the exhibition, right, so we have a setup. So on setup, I am passing this description, right? So in the description, I'm passing as a browser starter. So the same I have passed in the browser tear down also. Okay, so when it's come to the test body, right, so test body also, I'm sending this description of the method doing the, I mean, so here we are doing the Allure search thing, right? So here you can see that in the test body. So here also you can see this searching Allure report in the Bing, right? So here you can see the step level. So that is a step level. So this is Epic level, this is a feature level, and this is a step level, right? So these are the description in the report, right? So this is a step level. You can configure the text, right? So this is a so doing the Bing search. So if you come to the Bing search, right, so you can see here navigating the step here, right? So this is a test case where we are seeing as a failure. So then Bing navigating back, this is a test case, right? So again you can see this is a assertion that we are seeing failure one. Right, so when you come to here, you can see the severity here. Severity I have mentioned as a critical. So when you come here, you can see this severity, right? So severity I mentioned as a critical one. So that's the reason it's coming as a critical, right? And you can see this navigation forward and everything. And when you come to the test body, right? So you can see this Bing navigating forward is getting failed, and the respective skin chart is attached to the report, right? So this is a skin chart that attached to the report. So the same applies to the Google as well. So you can come here and you can see the Google, skin chart is attached, right? So this is a graphs, right? You can see, and this is a timeline, and this is a behavior, and this is a package. So we have only one package. So with the two test cases. So when it come to the behaviors, right? So you can see this Epic level. So we have configured, right? So Epic level, feature level, then feature level again, right? So when you come to here, so the same thing. So we have one Bing Epic, and we have one Google Epic, right? So you can see the first one is a Bing Epic, and with the Bing Epic we have Future. So this is a Future which is doing the Bing search. So these are the steps, right? So you can something like this, you can configure and you can share, which is will be, I mean, very useful when the business or product owners look at the report, right? So that's all. This is how we have to generate the simple Allure report with the skin chart attached. Okay. So I will share all the details into this video description. Please let me know if you have any comments. Okay. So thank you guys.